Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss in material handling system, that is industrial vehicles or truck. Now we can see this word industrial vehicles or truck. This is consists of two words. One is industrial, another is vehicle. So the vehicles or truck which is used in specifically used in industry, that is actually known as industrial vehicles or truck. So this is one of the most common group of material handling equipment which is used in industry as well as day-to-day distribution in warehouse or large store or transport depots, etc. in different places. So these are basically the industrial vehicles or truck. Okay, now this adjective industrial is used just because to differentiate from normal vehicle, which is normal vehicle like bus, lorry, truck, which is used for transportation of man, livestock or goods like these of things. Now this industrial vehicle is also differentiated into two types. One is power truck, another is non-power truck. Now in case of power truck, this power truck is also differentiated into three parts. One is normal power truck, another one is forklift truck, and a third one is the tractor. Now this all of these three is known as power truck. Now power truck means there is a source of power, inherent source of power available for running this type of trucks. Okay, the next one is non-power truck. Now non-power truck is also known as hand truck. Hand truck means there is no motive power. It doesn't contain any kind of power to run. Only manual movement helps to move this type of non-powered truck. Okay, manual movement, or it can be attached to any other type of power truck or powered vehicle. Okay, now this non-power truck or hand truck, these have no source of motive power. That's why they are generally moved manually, or they are also attached to other powered moving equipments. Okay, now this hand truck is also classified into three subgroups. One is two-wheel hand truck, another one is multiple-wheel hand truck, and another one is hand lift truck. Now, in case of two-wheel hand truck, basically this two-wheel hand truck is used for moving unit or unitized load like bags, barrels, then boxes, cartons like this. Then there is multiple wheel hand truck. Now this multiple wheel hand truck is basically different sets of hand truck, like you can see these are like of dollies or platform truck. Now this platform truck also differentiated into two type. One is tilt or balance type, another one is non-tilt type, that is rigid type. Okay, now there is another type of platform truck available, that is semi-life skid platform truck. Now this and the third one we have already known, that is hand lift truck. This is number one, number two, number three, four. So in case of hand lift truck, there are different type of mechanism available. One is hydraulic lifting mechanism, another is mechanical lifting mechanism. Now these both of these hydraulic and mechanical lifting mechanism are further classified into three part. Basically they are classified into the based on their geometrical construction or general constructional features, like pallet truck, platform truck, or special type of truck. Now coming to the power truck. Power truck is when a vehicle or truck contains its own source of motive power, that is called power truck. Basically own source of power means this can be powered by either oil or batteries or gas. Now this power truck is also classified into six groups. Basically their specification are dividing this power truck. So number one is the mode of action. for power truck. Mode of action means how the power truck is acting, how the power truck is acting. Now number two is power source. Now all you have already know that power source means the source of the motive power for this industrial truck. Now this power source may be differentiated into either oil or gas or batteries. Okay, then number three is wheel type. Number four, that is mode of control. Now mode of control means whether it is fully automated or semi-automated or manually handled. Manually handled means there is an operator who can handle the power truck. Okay, then height of lift, and the last one is mode of travel. Okay, by the six category this power truck is also differentiated. Now power trucks can be said as like different type of power truck is available, like fixed platform truck which is powered, and these fixed platform truck are two types. One is drop platform truck, another is drop center baggage truck. Then there is platform lift truck, pallet lift truck which is battery operated. Then there is walkie truck, straddle carrier, like this. Then there comes forklift trucks. Now among all the power industrial vehicles or truck family, most versatile, useful and widely used equipment is the industrial powered forklift truck, popularly known as FLT. These are self-loading, counterbalanced, powered wheeled vehicles. So specifically note these points. One is self-loading. It can take the loads from its own way. Then counterbalance, it is counterbalanced. Okay, then powered means powered by battery or gas or oil. Then wheeled vehicle, while the operator is sitting on the vehicle, or operator may not be sitting on the vehicle for fully automated vehicles, designed to raise, move and lower load on fork or other attachment as fastened to a mast which is fixed in form of the vehicle. Now what is mast? Mast is this thing is actually known as mast of the FLT. Now the specifically this forklift truck or FLT, their source of power is petrol diesel or LPG gas engine, or it can be a battery driven motor. This mast may be tilted forward or backward within a range for battery stability during movement with load or without load. Also, it can also facilitate loading and unloading. It can also move upwards and downwards. The mast may be a single mast or may be telescoping in design, which allows high lifting of the load for the truck that must run through the limited headroom area. Okay, now the operation of this mast and movement of the fork are through a hydraulic power pack which is available over here. The body of the truck is purposely built heavy as the counter load. See, we have already talked about counter loading thing. Now since it is a counter load is available while lifting load on the fork attachment, it also satisfies the self-loading part. Now solid rubber tires are also provided for operation for different conditions. So solid rubber tire is associated with this type of wheels. Okay, now front wheel is larger than of the rear wheel because this front wheel is actually counterbalancing the load, and the rear wheel for this FLT or for FLT, this rear wheel is actually the driving wheel. Forklift truck has some specifications. Now these specifications are based on different operating parameters, and these specifications also listed down as a form of operational point of view. Okay, so the number one of this number one specification of this FLT is the rated capacity at a specific load center. Now this rated capacity, it may be 1000 kg 2000 kg, like this. This rated capacity is already specified by the manufacturer. Then number two specification is the power source. Power source means either gas or diesel or battery or LPG. Now number three, which is very important, that is the turning radius of the FLT. Number four, that is the length, width and height, that is physical dimensions. Then number five, that is the mast height, which is very important thing as well. Now thereafter, the lift height. Lift height is also important, just because it is actually differentiating different type of forklift truck for small lift or larger lift. Then the specification of mast. Specification of mast includes either the mast is single or telescoping, it can tilt or non-tiltable type, retractable or not retractable type. Then the next specification is travel speed. Then the next specification for this FLT is the speed of lifting. Then floor clearance. Floor clearance means the clearance between the lower portion or the lower portion of this fork to the floor. Then free lift, then retractable fork, then fork size and attachment provide. So these are the basic specification to divide a FLT from one to another. Now there are other technical specifications are also available, that is motive power, then power transmission system, then tire specification, battery and charger specification, like this. So these are the basic things for which different forklift truck are being specified. Now coming to the capacity rating of the forklift truck. Capacity rating. Now FLT are specified for a rated capacity at a specific load center. Now load center is the distance from the hill. Hill means this one. This is the hill. Load center is the distance from hill of the fork to the assumed CG of the load. Assumed CG of the load. If we assume the CG of the load is at this point X, that is the assumed CG of the load. Okay, so load center is this distance from this point to this point, that is the load center distance. Okay, now the loading capacity of the truck has to be reduced accordingly so that the moment of the load about the front wheel does not exceed that of the counter loaded body of the truck. If that happens, then the truck will fall down in the front. Okay, so for that thing we have to find out what is the true capacity of forklift truck. Now if you see, true capacity of forklift truck or FLT is also related to the rated capacity, which is actually given by the manufacturer. Okay, now the true capacity is equal to the rated capacity into load center. Load center means from this point to this point, B to C distance. Okay, so this distance plus distance from A to B. A is where? A is the center point of the front wheel. From center point of the front wheel to the hill of the fork. So this distance, if we plus these two and we multiply with this rated capacity, then we can find out what is the true capacity of FLT. When I have found the true capacity of FLT, then we have to find out the maximum safe weight. Maximum safe weight is what? Maximum safe weight means the maximum weight which this FLT can carry. This maximum safe weight can be found out by this formula, that is the true capacity divided by the CG of the load from B. CG of the load from B means from this point to this point, this distance, this point to this point distance, plus distance from A to B. Distance from A to B means the hill of the fork to the center point of the wheel. So by this formula we can find out the maximum safe weight. Next thing is the turning radius and aisle width of FLT. So FLT can move freely through an aisle having its width at least 300 millimeter more than of the maximum width of the load or the FLT, whichever is higher. That means if the FLT is without load, then 30 millimeter more than the maximum width, and if there is some kind of load which is the length of the load is more than of FLT, then it must be more than of the 300 millimeter from that distance. Okay, so this is the basically total length or A which is being specified over here. Now the next thing is, however, this FLT has no work across the length of the this aisle, like stacking or unstacking into rack in a warehouse system. The minimum aisle width requirement can be determined by these factors. So first one is the width of the aisle. Width of the aisle is, you can easily see, the maximum distance starting from this, considering the turning radius and the clearance. This total distance is the width of the aisle. Then number two, that is the B, which is the distance from the center line, to the point where the truck turns, and their rear wheel are situated over here. This rear wheel are turned to its extreme position. So that is the distance, or this front wheel turns coming to this extreme position. This distance is the specifically specified by this B. Now C is the clearance. Clearance, you can see here is the half clearance, considering the front side clearance and the back side clearance, the total clearance is considered at C. And TR is the turning radius. Turning radius is starting from this point to this radius. This radius is the turning radius. Then length of the weight on the fork. This is the fork of this FLT, and this is the length. And X is the distance between center line of the fork front wheel to the heel of the fork. Okay. Now from this we can find out the total aisle length, that is the turning radius. Turning radius from this point to this point, this is this length TR plus X, this distance plus L, and these two clearance, considering this C by 2, total is C. Now from this we can find out turning radius, that is equal to A minus of X plus L plus C. So from this point we can find out easily the turning radius and aisle width. This is A, aisle width and turning radius from this figure. So if we got this turning radius, then we can find out this aisle width, and if we got this aisle width, then we can find out the turning radius for this FLT. What we are going to study is about the power source or the power of FLT. Now depending on the power, we have already discussed that there are different power sources available for FLT, like gas powered or oil powered or battery powered. Now the engine driven trucks are completely cheaper than of battery operated truck. Moreover, the engine driven truck can be used almost without the need of electricity. Despite all this, the number of battery trucks continues to increase, particularly capacities up to 3 tons due to the factors like overall lower maintenance cost, lack of smoke, fume and noise. So depending on eco-friendliness, that's why the battery driven trucks are mostly used in different industries like warehouse. Okay, now these battery operated trucks are particularly suitable for warehousing and operations in confined areas. However, the prerequisite to using battery operated truck is availability of electricity and battery charging facility. So that's why battery powered truck is very commonly used. Okay, Now there are different type of battery is available in the market. Number one is the lead acid battery, and number two is the nickel alkaline battery. Now this lead acid battery or nickel alkaline battery, both of these battery have sufficient ampere hour capacity to ensure that at least one full day operation of any FLT. Now the difference between these two batteries are basically lead acid battery. These batteries are actually lower cost, but it can give a greater energy or kilowatt hour capacity in a given space, but it has a lower internal resistance. In case of nickel alkaline battery, it has a very longer life, better mechanical strength, non-corrosive electrolyte, that's why it doesn't freeze. Okay, and it has also a shorter recharge period considering to this lead acid battery. Actually this lead acid battery is local made batteries, and nickel alkaline are manufactured and in covered type of batteries. So these batteries are also used in larger industries. These batteries are used in smaller industries. This battery voltage is also standardized by the manufacturer. Okay, now depending on different truck capacity and type of truck, this battery average battery voltage is differentiated. Like for suppose a ton, 5 ton to 8 ton truck, 36 volt to 48 volt battery is being used for platform type FLTs. Okay, now there is the battery rating. Now this battery rating, it is very essential that the sufficient battery capacity is to be provided to allow uninterrupted operation of the truck during operation period. The capacity of battery is rated in ampere hour for a 6 hour discharge period. 6 hour discharge period means if this rating is divided by 6, it gives a current draw in amperes, which is continued to 6 hour, and that will completely discharge the battery. Okay, the battery size for the truck of these various capacities have been standardized by the manufacturer. For that thing, battery selection is also very important. Now this battery selection is based on energy rating for a proposed duty cycle of a truck within a given period between two battery changes. So this energy calculation for different operations are based on certain charts and formula which is already adopted by Electrical Industrial Truck Association through different field studies. Now from that, we can easily calculate the energy required for a FLT. Now FLT can move through a horizontal floor and some inclined floor in case of any warehouse. Now in case of horizontal length of run, if any FLT go through any horizontal plane, then there is a chart or table which is provided by this association, which actually indicates the total watt hour or approximate watt hour of battery required based on the total load. Total load means the load of the truck and load of the material, total load with the length of the run, which is actually given in feet. Now for that thing, we have a table which is already given. Now if the truck is going upward or downward, now for that thing some extra power is also required. Now for downward purpose, we will always use the gravity principle of material handling system. For that thing, if the percentage of inclination is more than 5% downward, no power is required for this thing because we will use gravity principle for this. Now for the upgradation of this path, extra power is required for traveling up, that is equal to total load. Total load means load of the truck plus material load into length of the inclined path in feet. into percentage of inclination, how many, what is the percentage of inclination? If there is the inclination is given in theta, then we have to calculate its percentage of inclination into 0.013, which is a constant term. Now this is the extra power required for traveling up. Okay, now for traveling down, we have to take care of this formula. Now for lifting the load, some energy is also required. Now for lifting energy, that is equal to tons of load which you need to be lift into height of lift. What is the height of lift from bottom to the top? Okay, into 2. From this formula we can find out full lifting energy. Now if you need to unload any material, then you have to unload, then you have to lift the material to the stack. Then after unloading, you have to move down the fork to the original position. For that thing, you have you need some extra energy for free lifting, which is 1/3 of the full lifting energy. Okay, now again, you also know that some fork is also known as tilting fork. Now for that type of fork, some tilting energy is also required. Now tilting energy is equal to the tons of load, and for empty tilt, that is one third of the tons of load, or 1/3 of the full tilting energy